Welcome to the How To Studio. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. In this video, I'll show you how you can fix the automatic repair issue that you might have been experiencing on your Windows computer. So if your computer is continuously loading and you're being taken to the automatic repair screen, then this is the video for you. So in the automatic repair screen, you're going to click on the button that says Advanced Options. And then in the Choose an Option section, you're going to click on Troubleshoot. And then in the Troubleshoot section, you're going to click on Advanced Options. And then in the Advanced Options section, you're going to click on the Command Prompt, which is in the right top hand right corner. And then on your keyboard, you're going to press Control and a colon and then click Enter. And then you're going to type DIR and then you're going to click Enter. So how you know you're in the correct directory is if you're seeing program files, users, Windows. If your drive is not the C drive, you might want to try other letters for it to work, but it's usually the C drive. So on your keyboard, next you're going to type in cd/windows/system32/config, and then once you're done typing that, then you're going to click Enter. Then you're going to type MD backup. Then click Enter. Then you're going to type copy, star, dot, another star, and then backup. And then you're going to press on your keyboard Enter. And then you're going to type cd /regback and then Enter. And then you're going to type DIR and Enter. And then you should not be seeing all zeros. It's all zeros on my computer environment. But if you're seeing all zeros, then it's not going to work. You should be seeing a list of numbers. But next thing you're going to type is copy, *, *, *, and 2 dots and click Enter. Press Enter on your keyboard. And then next, you're going to type A and then press Enter. And now you can type exit and press Enter, and then it should see the screen where you click continue, exit, and continue to Windows 10. And there you have it. It should be restarting your Windows as normal. I hope this video was helpful. See you in the next one.